So, you've heard of Calendly, maybe even Chili Piper. There's loads of different scheduling tools for teams on the market, but have you heard of Calendar.com? Well, today we're going to overview Calendar.com, whether it's any good, how it works, and everything that you need to know about this software. It's an interesting tool that combines calendar and scheduling abilities in one application to help you get started with you and your team. So, to begin with, can you use this as an individual? Yes, you can. There's a basic pricing with the ability to add calendar, and you can also add more calendars as you see fit as well. I'll talk about that a little bit later. But where can you download calendar.com? Well, it is available on iOS, Android, web, and with a Chrome extension as well. And it has apparently over 80,000 teams using it actively. So on screen now is the pricing. As I mentioned, you get a basic pricing, which you can use an individual or you can use as a team, but there are some limitations to what you can access as part of that. The pricing starts at around about $10 per user per month with a $12 premium option that you can upgrade to. And it's roughly the same pricing as you get with Calendly.com. So before we dive into this video today is sponsored by Zapier. You'll hear a little bit more about them later, and you can connect them with the likes of Calendar.com too. So why is Calendar.com slightly different to other tools on the market like Calendly? Well, it has the ability to manage a calendar in here. In here, this is the view you get for being able to create events and be able to start scheduling meetings. Now, that's quite a difference because in Calendly, you can't navigate your actual calendar, which is a nice bonus to have. Although one thing I will say about this is it's not the most attractive, but it is functional. Up here, you can move around dates, you can set your working hours, and you can choose your availability accordingly. And up here, there's a way to add additional workspaces, and you can add more calendar experiences. So for example, you're not just limited to Google Calendar. You can add Apple, you can add the likes of Exchange and Outlook, as well as more calendar apps. But there are some limitations in terms of pricing. I believe on the free plan that I'm demonstrating to you now, you can only add one account outside of Calendar.com's access. So how can this be helpful? Well, the benefit is once you're able to see your calendar, you can also see your upcoming meetings and you can plan the time around it. For example, you can see anything connected and all of the details accordingly, which is really helpful. Anything creation of events you can set as repeating, choose the calendar that you have connected up with the account and add relevant description and information. I checked what access you could get with Google Meet and things like that, and there isn't some availability in the basic pricing, but you can add a meeting link if you want to create a video conferencing straight from there. But that is a premium feature as part of the packages there, which is a bit of a shame. Ever wanted to automate things, but you lack the coding skills? You can now do that with Zapier with no code. Zapier is the leader in automation, allowing you to take your workflows to the next level with a suite of automation tools. You can go from an idea to reality in no time, setting up triggers for simple workflows and for even more advanced ones. That's why over 2.2 million companies use and trust Zapier. And thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video. So you're probably wondering, what else can I do with this application? Well, this is where it's sort of like a Calendly replacement. If you click on your workspace, you can create a scheduling link. And the scheduling page looks a little bit like this because I have no open setups right now. Now, if I go ahead and press create a scheduling event, you can create something called a round robin, which is great for inviting meetings with multiple hosts. And also you can create a one-to-one. So in this case, I might say, this one could be called Vendor Pro as a meeting slot that I typically have. You can also allocate it to a scheduling page, give it a color and write down blah, 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 blah about this particular session. Now you can go over here and press continue. And this is where you can add your availability. Now, what's nice as well is you can choose things that are best suited to you. So Monday mornings aren't good for me as an example. And you may be able to add the date range as well. So for example, you could have the date range being particular times as you might be leaving work and things like that. Now you can only set one duration as part of this, but you can have it as 15 minutes or you can choose from a custom duration if you want to. So down here, I'm going to go and press continue and I can add a location for this. Now I can add a Google Meet, but as I mentioned earlier, it is limited to the pricing plans, but you can also set a in-person meeting web conference, and you can add a web link here and a web pin if you have something like Zoom that's recurring. So there are some advanced options here, like inviting guests, block schedules, and things like that, that you can modify as you see fit. And I'm gonna say this one is in person. So, but I'm just gonna choose that place in Australia. And you can also set up notifications for each of your meetings. I believe some of them are limited, but as you can see, that meeting scheduling has been created, and this is what it will look like. So in this case, I can set up a meeting and naturally see everything like the title, description that I added randomly, location, and the meeting minutes, or the meeting access. So down here, I can create a meeting poll. This is limited to premium, so if you're looking to access that, you'll be limited naturally accordingly. But I can go ahead and create more of these for different scenarios, and I believe you can create up to 5 as part of the basic plan. So over here, there's one that allows you to scheduling reporting, which gives you events scheduled from time slot links. These will allow you to see upcoming meetings and any events that you can export as well. You can also use this feature called Find a Time. Now, this is quite helpful for those who are looking to find a slot for somebody and you want to recommend something more on the go. So for example, you could move this about and find a time for that person. And if I go ahead and create a link. So Find a Time is a way that you can set a period of time out. For example, in this case, you could drag an item here and it will help to create an event in a time period in the day, which is quite helpful. Just a faster way to narrow down if you've got a busy calendar. Over here, you can manage administration, and this is where you can change things like your workspace and meeting locations. It's really easy to set that up. And over here, you can connect more additional calendars. Like I mentioned earlier, there's Office 365, Outlook, and Exchange servers as well, but some of those are limited to actually the premium pricing if you're looking to connect multiple ones. You can change your availability of your calendar here, and you can see the integrations that are available. Zapier is a pro feature, will help you connect up different automations and allow you to use their services as part of it. So in terms of features and functionality, this calendar application is good in the basic plan. It gives you a calendar view to see everything that's coming up, allows you to organize meetings if you've got the premium with the likes of video conferencing softwares, and is really more of an enhanced way to be able to use things like Calendly. The benefit to this is you can add up to 5 different types of meetings, and you're not limited, or you are limited to how many durations you added, but not limited to just one meeting link that you have to reoccur on use, which is very helpful. So this gets a lot better when you upgrade to premium, because there's more features like meeting polls, unlimited schedule blocker, and much more that take your meetings to the next level. But the application is a lot more approachable in terms of how you can have a calendar app alongside it. So this was a review of calendar.com. If you're looking for something that brings to life a calendar alongside scheduling links, this might be the calendar solution for you. It's not the most attractive, but it seems to get the job done with a lot of decent features for helping you to plan and organize meetings. So thank you so much for stopping by. As I mentioned, toolfinder.co is a resource for finding tools and resources. If you're interested in exploring it, please do jump over to our platform to find more scheduling tools. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I look forward to helping you with a future video or useful resource. So do make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Cheerio for now.